Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Shana-Kay. I'm so excited about this video because it has been a long time coming, you guys. So as you can see from the title, I gave my small powder bathroom, I guess, or half bathroom or powder room or whatever it is that they call it. First of all, the landlord did not paint that bathroom in the same color as the other parts of the house. I just don't like how it look. So because I'm gonna like it, I took it upon myself and said, listen, I'm going to make over this bathroom. I'm just going to buy the paint, buy whatever I need to fix up that bathroom. I'm going to show you guys a clip of what the bathroom looked like before. Hi, I'm wearing a mask because we're in these colonial times. Alright, so I'm inside of Rapid True Valley right now and I'm looking for the paint, and I'm also looking to see if they have any other thing that I might can use in the bathroom to kind of like, you know, add to the decor and stuff. So I'm going to get the paint first thing and then I'm going to walk through the aisles. So I'm bringing you guys with me. So come along. I really like these baskets, but on my list that I had made for the things that I really want to put in the bathroom, I had a basket on there and I want a basket underneath the sink to maybe like store my tissue and maybe some towels and stuff in there. And the price is like $6,000. So I don't know about this. Probably have to go find something. But I really like these kind of baskets.
Gardenia.
Alright. First of all, I don't know anything about paint. The brand no matter. Does the brand matter? I think so. I guess they have the most expensive stuff and then they have the cheaper stuff. So here I find Gardenia in this one. So these are white, accent base, off white, Gardenia. Yeah, it's a Gardenia. Got this paint. So these cute vase you can probably put on top of the toilet, or you can put it on because the sink, the wash sink that we have in there, there's a little bit of space that I think this could hold, but I'm going to evaluate it some more first before
rolling.
I need a small one or a big one because the roller
that change. Change
3 inch.
Same on either stitch.
3 inch. So I don't need a 6 inch. This one would be good with the roller.
I don't use a roller, yeah.
So I get a 3 inch brush, and my mother-in-law should have a roller at her house. So I'm going there to get the roller, and then this is all I'm getting here. Should I get what the mountain tape? The one that I have at home finished?
It's school stuff.
Mountain cave. Okay. Not making a mountain cave. Alright, let's go. Jesus. $2,617. And you know that Rapid already have tax in their prices. But I also want a soap dispenser. A cuter one for the bathroom. Because the one I have in the bathroom right now is just a regular Dial bottle, but I want a more fancy one. I had bought two on Amazon, and those two that I bought, I have one in the kitchen and one in my bathroom, but they're sold out. I was trying to see if I could find something locally. You know what? I'm going to check Max's and see what Max's have. Right. No, no like this. And then again, it's a complete set and stuff. This is not bad, but it's $1,999 plus tax. Huh. You like this? I like the white, I like the brown, but I still have to think about it. Still have to think about it. Let's go over to where they have the this one. I can get into this one. $14.90. I can get into this.
Do you know what it looks like? Roll it up again.
No.
No. What does that look like?
Oh my god.
You can see it. Oh no. There's
so many nice stuff in here that make us like indecisive. Anytime I come to Maxi, I'm always indecisive. Like, me just don't know. I'll come in here with a plan and then it could go straight through the door because I think about all the other things, all the other faces in the house.
Spot is right here for both sides. So what we did was use the hooks for the curtain and mark the spot. So X or O marks the spot. So my first time using a drill, I'm actually kind of nervous, but first down.
Use like a second finger and press it. Okay. And then you're going to put this hand up at the top.
Here.
If I need hand strength, you can put it in here. What are you going to be doing with that money?
I know I look hella tired. As you can see, it's a yellow light in here. Currently, see, gone. Currently switching it out for a white light.
get lost inside my thoughts, and when I start to think, oh, the tunnel closest starts to end up on the brink. I tried so hard, but all these scars, they cut so deep I bleed. I fell so fast from heaven, it's like someone clipped my wings. Now I'm falling, and I can't see the ground. Can we stop this gravity? It keeps bringing me down.
Alright, so finally a tour of the bathroom. After all that detail as to what I did, what I went through to get this bathroom to look like this. So I wanted to show you guys over this section here where we have the mirror. We're having this water spot in there. We rented the place like this and we technically, I didn't like it. I hated it actually, but there's nothing that we could do about it. And we actually really liked the place. So we just compromised on it and decide, you know, what we can do to actually fix this. So we went to Rapid, and Rapid has, we were looking for like maybe tile strips, the peel and stick tile strips that you might use for kitchen backsplash. We're trying to figure out something that would be budget friendly to use to cover that area. So we thought about vinyl. When we contacted the guy to print the vinyl, after my husband did a superb job at creating it, it was like $3,000, and I feel like I wanted to do this bathroom on a budget. So this only cost $700 and something, like $742 or something like that. And this is actually I think it's a cupboard liner, and they have various different colors. This one, I decided on this one because it kind of matched the tone of the bathroom, the theme of the bathroom, like a beachy theme, but it has cream and it has that wood look, so it matches. So I thought I'd go with this one, and we just cut it properly, line it up and set it on there. You wouldn't tell that that water spot was there all along. And the good thing about this is not permanent, you can always take it off when you're about to move out. Now right here I have this soap dispenser. So last set of soap dispensers that I bought were on Amazon. So I was looking for a soap dispenser. Majority of the places I've gone to, Rapid was really expensive, Maxi's was expensive, and guess what? I found this one at Fontana for $1,000 plus tax. Workout in my favor, because it kind of look exactly like the ones that I bought on Amazon. Over here I have this four plants that I got from IKEA. The towels over here, I have these towels I've had for a long time. I don't even remember where I got them. Might have been maybe in a towel set or maybe a bathroom set. I don't remember where I got them, but I've had them for a long time. Of course I have brown and cream or yellow looking, which goes with the tone of the place. So I just put it in here. Down here we have this basket. Now I wanted something for storage, and I was looking everywhere to see if I could find a storage basket or so, just to put some stuff in, like the tissue, maybe additional towels. So when you want to go to the gym and we don't really want to go upstairs and stuff. And I also have Febreze in here for when maybe we have guests, or have paper towel in here if it is that you want to use paper towel instead of the towels. Now this corner I have this glass vase. I've had this for a while in an awkward place in my living room. I've always been looking for a proper place to put it. So this tall glass vase, I got it at Rapid. I don't remember the price, maybe $2,000 something plus tax, closer to $3,000 I believe. And the flowers I got from Maxi. Now everybody knows that faux plants are so expensive, especially Maxi just expensive on a whole. But I really like your stuff, you know, them always have some really nice stuff. I got this, I think I paid maybe close to $3,000 for the two of them, to be honest. And what I did was just tuck a piece inside the glass vase and a piece outside of it. So that look really cute to me. And the stones that are in there, I also got from Maxi. They normally sell like the stones in like a bag, a white bag. I actually want to put more stones in there, but not right now. I don't have money to spend right now. But I really love this. I really love how everything came together. So over here now, I have these 11 by 14 wall frames. And I got these on eBay like months upon months ago, before the pandemic actually. And I don't remember what I paid for them, but I'll try to find them and link them in the description box. I love these frames. I was actually considering to put them in my bedroom, but I say, you know what, let me just put them in the bathroom and figure something else out for my bedroom. So these are 11 by 14 and they come with 8 by 10 mat. Yeah, so it's an 8 by 10 and the frame itself is 11 by 14. I created, well, not me, I'm not taking the credit, my husband created it. He created this picture that you see in there. He's very artistic, you guys. He doesn't take credit for it, but he's so much better than I am when it comes on to like paint and, you know, like he just needs to see something and voila. So I got, because we're going with a beach theme in the bathroom, so this camera does work out. I'm a videographer and I'm also a YouTuber and I'm always using camera, so it kind of seemed fitting. He added some little gold dots on there. This looks like a sand and this looks like a border. This looks like the sea at the back. So you see where we're going with that, and it's kind of blue. So love, love, love this. All right, moving on over here, I have these curtains. These were actually very long curtains to the ground. And my mother-in-law, she kind of sews, kinda-ish. So I can get her to hem something for me, but I can't really get her to take in something for me. But I asked her to cut it for me. So what I did was use a tape measure and I measured the length of the window, how high I wanted the, what you call this again? Curtain rod, how tall I wanted it. And I measured it to 30. Really love how it turned out because I didn't want to leave the window like this. It's not like anybody can really see in here, but I feel like it more bougie. Curtain rod is from a Chinese store. I paid $925 for it. I thought it wouldn't fit, but it did. And I love it because it's black and it goes well with the black frame. Here we have another frame. So it was twin frames I bought on eBay. And this picture also, my husband created it. I was actually thinking about buying this on Etsy, you guys. So my husband said, no, sir, where you get money from? So why you can go up on Etsy and buy a painter? All of these do it in Canva. Voila. Canva and the rest was history. And my husband do it actually, it's not me, because I don't know, I'm not creative to this level where there's art and paint and whatever. So down here I have these, you guys have seen this candle a thousand times.
Mahogany.
This candle is actually mahogany. I'm having a challenge with the pronunciation. Teak wood, and it's a scented candle. And I really love it because it smells like perfume, like a manly smell, and I really love it. Over a year now. One year, probably 2 years now. This, I'm sure you guys have seen this before. We just move it from one place and repurpose it and put it in here. Same thing for the floors. Floors from Maxi. This is from Maxi. And I don't know if you guys can see where I kind of balance out the color. So you have like a little bit, maybe this is copper, you have silver, you have black with black frames, and you see where I'm going with this. And I got this at Bashko. This has a body wash in there, it also has a lotion in there. And I bought it because I was actually thinking to use a pump bottle, but that never really worked out. But when I have guests or so, you wash your hand and you want to like use a lotion, you know, you have lotion in here. So I really like that. And over here I have my scale behind the door and I have tissue in the bathroom. This mat, I think you guys have seen this mat before. It is nude and I love nude, as you can see.
And the I think I bought this at maybe Maxi or Rapid for a while now, but I love the fact that it has that sand color and sand beachy theme, water looking, sand looking, a little bit of blue, nudes all over the place. So I really love how everything turned out in this space. I hope you guys liked this video. If you did, thumbs me up. Don't forget to subscribe. Remember, if you want to see more videos like this, subscribe to my YouTube channel and also comment, leave me a thumbs up, all of that good stuff. Until next time, I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye.